know, this is Gage's first time using this. He's never used the bagging system on my other mower either, so this is a new experience for him. But we raised it up on 4 inches. As you guys know, I like to cut my grass a little higher. It's a tall fescue. So he's just going to make a few rounds around the yard on 4 inches, and we'll see how it does. Curious how much of my yard I can get in that hopper. And of course, to do this properly, we'd have to blow everything out. Like I said earlier, we're not doing a full-blown cleanup today. We're just kind of practicing a little bit. This is just basically so Gage can get a little bit of practice and experience before we take it out on a customer's property. He's really good with equipment, really good with, you know, catching on to how things work, but he's just young and super shy, so it kind of takes him a little extra time to get used to things. So this is a good place to practice. Here's where he's making his turn at with those tires. So pretty tight turn, and it's not doing any kind of turf damage. It's kind of like I've told you guys before, with aggressive tires or with tweels, your technique when you turn really has everything to do with whether or not you tear up the turf. If you turn right, you're not going to tear anything up. load. There you go. Go ahead and finish up that piece in the front and another pass on the side. That's pretty much it. So that's how much is in a full hopper. My yard, guys, I've said this before, my yard, the part that I mow, is 3,500 square feet. So he's probably done about 3,000 square feet of it on that one hopper full. Of course, you know, the leaves aren't super heavy. We've kept up with the leaves and stuff, so it's not like this is a one-time cleanup type of deal. But he's cutting off probably an inch or so of grass, you know, good thick grass, and the leaves that are mixed in with it. So honestly, I feel like that's a pretty good capacity for something that size. And just running high lift blades, so there's not a whole lot of mulching going on other than, you know, running through the deck and then running through the impeller. Okay, go ahead and put it in the trailer, Gage. I don't know, I guess you could just drive it in there. You can try backing it in if you want, either way. See how well it fits in the trailer. Should have plenty of space. I mean, this is a pretty good sized trailer, so. Good job, son. So he kept it kind of tight to that side to give himself room to get on and off, but I mean, that's lots and lots of space. And we just got it parked over the axle because the big Z3X, the 61, is at the shop. Solenoid went bad on it, so they're replacing that. Not a real big deal, just won't have it today, so we're gonna go get a few done that aren't very big with the PV13. Kind of test everything out. So, thanks for watching, guys. Get out there and make some money, and we'll catch you on the next one.